All right, coming back with an unorthodox sort of video. Today we are going to be reacting for the first time I've ever heard this song, Dr. Dre feat. Eminem, The Gospel, which is on the DLC for GTA Online. God knows why they're still updating the damn game. We want GTA 6 already, guys. But okay, so the contract DLC, this is part of the music that Dr. Dre helped produce. He's on the song with the DOC. Who the fuck cares who that is? And then we have Eminem on here, which is the reason why I'm reviewing this in the first place. So let's go ahead and get started.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Look at these lyrics.
What? What? Yeah. Dre, you ready? Ooh. Come on.
Yeah, we gotta
all right. Check. Cut him undercover, timeless, ready for him, progress, feeling like I'm just getting started, two shots back for my dearly departed, you are now dealing with a monster, oh shit, profits, Dr. Dre, bitch, I'm a prophet, Black Wall Street, niggas know where the stock is, try me, niggas never see me, but it ain't hard to find me, unwinding, shit's...
So let's break down the first like 8 bars and see this over here. So again, he's probably hasn't even written this, okay? Remember, Eminem ghostwrites a lot for Dr. Dre. But again, this is still pretty good, right? And think about it here. Now dealing with the monster, bust shit, boss shit, profits, Dr. Dre, bitch, I'm a prophet, Black Wall Street, niggas know where the stock is. That's pretty hard, okay? Black Wall Street, a reference to, what, 100 years ago, there was like one block of relative black wealth that got destroyed after a rape accusation from a black guy on a white girl, and the white people came and destroyed their town. So yes, a lot of blacks know this as something of, you know, their virtue of like, wow, even under, you know, under Jim Crow, left to our own devices, when we're segregated, we can make a lot of money. So he's ballin', like it's Black Wall Street, which for them, and by them I mean African Americans, is impressive, okay? Now, is Black Wall Street even close to the Wall Street now? No, but was it as corrupt? Probably not. So I will give him some credit, okay?
Blinding, still grinding, uprising. Stop talking about the past, I'm the future, nigga. Nigga like me, still here, motherfucker, go figure. Looking for my next gold digger. This summer here gonna be colder than winter. Already told you, I fold you like hundreds of billions, and you can go missing, put that on my children. Bet that.
Okay, now here's another set of bars that are interesting right here. Here, unwinding, shit's blinding, still grinding, uprising. Again, so he's like a 50-something-year-old man. He's still going for it. He's still, you know, he's already past his prime, quite honestly. He peaked like 20 years ago. But that being said, he's still grinding, you know. He had the Beats headphones. That was a really big cultural phenomenon 10 years ago. And then also imagine that he's producing other stuff. Now, will it ever come out? Who knows? But here we go with him saying... stop talking about the past, I'm the future, nigga. So he's basically saying, you know, yes, you can talk about the albums that he made in the 90s, but he's still going on. He still has this delusion, you could say, or, you know, that he's still relevant and that he's still going to release music in the future or do something in business that'll keep him pertinent in rap, kind of like Jay-Z. But again, it's not here yet. So is he capping? Who knows? And then it's like, nigga, like me still here, motherfucker, go figure. Okay. So again, he's saying, I'm still here, I'm not irrelevant yet, I'm making stuff on a video game soundtrack. Okay, cool, man. Hey, you know, Survival by Eminem on COD Ghost, GOAT, really good song. Now, looking for my next gold digger. Now, this is obviously a reference to him getting divorced by his wife, Nicole, I think. And obviously, he's saying, looking for another gold digger, so he didn't trust his wife with him. I don't know why they got divorced in particular, I don't really care, but the point is that... he knows himself that, you know, he's a guy in his 50s. Like, if he wants to marry a girl in her 20s or 30s, it's going to be a gold digging situation. So he's looking for his next gold digger. So he's showing a little bit of self-awareness here, which is kind of cool. All right. And then he's saying, I already told you, I fold you like hundreds of billions. So again, he's saying, I'm billionaire. All right. Or getting there. And he's exacerbating, or not exacerbating, he's exaggerating his wealth. Very common in rap music. Now let's go ahead and keep playing. All right.
Nigga, what? Regret that. Run it up, and I'm about to sum it up. This shit here, that problem, living at the bottom of a bottle, full throttle, my motto, fucking with me like fucking with the Lalo. That awful, in your nostril, in a brothel, this is gospel, yeah, I'ma need all that pronto. Yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir.
Okay, these last several bars was basically filler. I think Eminem definitely wrote this because it's a lot of in syllable rhymes, as in like full throttle, my motto, fuck that, we fucking with the lotto, awful in your nostril, in a brothel, a gospel, pronto. So a lot of rhymes here. Dr. Dre is not typically the one that would conduct these sort of rhymes. I don't think he can really string these words together, but he does rhyme them pretty well. He has a cool voice and all that. But also keep in mind, there's no substance in here, which is like another Eminem thing. Like, you know, very complex rhymes, really good delivery, but again, what is the substance of this? There isn't none. So let's go ahead and keep playing. Till I die, give a fuck if you bitches die. Put a motherfucking hole in your face. Back up, bitch, don't even try. I am that motherfucker, been the coldest. Why you on that? No one know us. Overdose to one dope is. Yeah, hip hop shit sell better than the coke did. So what is this chorus right here? Barely even a chorus. It's not really catchy at all, which is kind of a problem. If you want a radio song, which I guess they're not wanting, you would want something that's catchy. But yeah, hip hop shit sell better than the coke did. So this is a pretty good lyric, because there's a lot of black guys that are drug dealers at first and then go ahead and do something along the lines of rap or hip hop producing and all this. And he's saying, I'm selling more doing hip hop than coke, which is, again, something that seems kind of stupid to white people. But if you think about it, you know, when you're selling drugs, I have no idea what it's like, but I just, you know, reading, it is like tens of thousands of dollars a month. But at the same time, if you're making more than that selling raps, which is something that is completely unproductive, something that probably won't get you killed, probably something that won't get you a felony and years in jail, you're basically doing really well. So yeah, if you're making more on hip hop safely than doing coke on the verge of death every week, then you're doing a lot better than a lot of your brothers in the hood, so to speak. So let's go ahead and play this video, which is going to be the 90-second Eminem verse, and see whether or not it is fire emoji. Yeah, hip-hop shit sell better than the coke did. Like a satanic cult, it's an old ritual slaughtering goats, bitch. You're fucking with the original flow, sick, and anybody can get it. COVID. Fucking with that, I don't know shit. Okay, so let's go ahead and go for the first three bars. Like a satanic cult, it's like an old ritual slaughtering goats. Bitch, you're fucking with the original flow sick and anybody can get it COVID. Okay, so again, so this is the gospel. This is a vague notion of religion and such, okay? And he's saying, like a satanic cult, I'm slaughtering goats, which is, again, a play on the word or the term of goat, which is greatest of all time, which is a reference to an Eminem song unreleased from the King Mathers LP that never came out in 2007, where he said he's one of the goats, or is the goat, the greatest of all time. And he's saying he's slaughtering goats. So again, he's killing, you know, verbally, these best of all times. He's saying he's doing better than Nas, Jay-Z, and these people. At least he's alluring to that. He would never say that because he's a pussy. But again, and then he's saying, okay, he's the flow sick. He's the original. Anybody can get his shit. COVID. And again, Eminem's a Corona simp. He really thinks it's a big deal. So his politics do suck ass, but I don't really care. We're gonna go ahead and keep going. It was so sharp, I could slit my own fucking throat with it. So rich, I got more chips than my shoulders, and I'm about as approachable as a roaches. Okay, I could slit my own fucking throat with it. It's so sharp, right? So he's saying he's writing things so sharp, as in smart and acute and clever, that it could cut his own throat with it, as in he can kill himself with his own rhymes because they're that good. And he's also so rich, he's got so much money, and he's got more chips, again, alluring to casinos, and then saying that he has more chips, as in betting money, than he does on his shoulders, as in chip on your shoulder, because again, he's a guy who grew up poor, who wanted to make it in rap ever since he was a teenager. And he's saying he's so rich, he's got more money than he has drive at this point. So it's a self-owned, because he knows that he's running out of content. But again, he doesn't realize that when he's writing it, because he's not as smart as I am. But again, this is really good rhyming so far, okay? And he's also about as approachable as a roach is, which again is a very obvious rhyme scheme, but it's also really clever, and so far as most people wouldn't be able to visualize this. But again, nobody is saying that a roach is approachable. That's disgusting, unless you're Chinese and you eat bugs. But overall, he's rhyming approach with roach. That's pretty simple, but again, really good. It's good. Right. Just so better steer clear from it. Here comes a nuclear bomb for your eardrums. Lyricism at its most fearsome and fierce. We're on another tier like your tear ducts. Upper echelon, your career sucked. It was sheer luck, like a fucking leprechaun with his beard cut. Okay, here comes a nuclear bomb for your eardrums. Lyricism at the most fearsome and fierce. We are in another tier like a tears duct. Upper echelon, your career sucked. Like a sheer luck, like what? Like a fucking leprechaun with its beard cut. So this sounds completely incoherent to me. But again, we have to read into the rhymes. And again, I've not heard this before at all. So bar for bar, I'm digesting it all as we speak. And right now, my synopsis of what he's saying is, he's so good, he's going to burst your eardrums, which, I mean, it's, I'm not going to give my review of the song yet. It's not even halfway done. But lyricism at the most fearsome and fierce. So these are synonyms, but again, they sound almost the exact same, which is awesome, the way he rhymes it. And then we are from another tier, like a tier ducks, upper echelon. So that's an amazing rhyme, because tier as in like a tier ranking, as in different levels, he's on another level, a higher one, like a tier duct as in you're crying, duct as in like the area of your eye when you're about to cry. Then upper echelon, again, another synonym for tier, as in he's above another level, upper echelon. So he's saying they're on another level, like the upper echelon of when you're crying. He's above you, going down. So again, pretty good. Amazing. Phenomenal scheme right there. Then your career sucked. It was sheer luck, as in like you got lucky that you got famous in the first place. Maybe he's dissing the Island Boys, but the Island Boys are goats. They're awesome. Super catchy song. They don't even have to rhyme in English. They're that good. These fucking Cubanos, I'm telling you. Anyways, like a fucking leprechaun with his beard cut. So sheer luck, your career suck. It was sheer luck, like what? Like a leprechaun with its beard cut. Sheer luck? What is a leprechaun with its beard cut? Is it sheer luck? That makes no fucking sense. Sherlock Holmes? Sherlock Khan? I don't know what that means. I don't know yet. The Punisher, weapon drawn with a beer gut. He's slower than a Decepticon with his gear stuck. And I what? I serial killing your Kellogg's. I love checks and I hate tricks. And you're okay. Still a Punisher, weapon drawn with a beard gut. So Punisher, which is again a good reference because he did do a comic book crossover with the Punisher in 2009 during the Relapse era. Punisher, another reference to Frank Castle, a great anti-hero. Also referencing a good show from like the 2018 era with Walking Dead actor, what's his name? Jon Bernthal. Again, good show. Weapon drawn, because obviously the Punisher uses weapons with a beer gut. Now, the Punisher doesn't really have a beer gut. Does Eminem have a beer gut? Low-key, yes. He is, like, almost 50 years old, so this is to be expected. And then you're slower than a Decepticon because it with its gear stuck. Another Transformer reference, a reference to Megan Fox as well. Megan Fox, girlfriend of Machine Gun Kelly. Machine Gun Kelly, who got his ass kicked into Pop Punk by Eminem 3 years ago. And I what? I serial kill and you're Kellogg's. So again, he's killing cereals. He's a serial killer. He's killing people and you're a Kellogg's. So he's going to kill you. Okay? Now let's keep going. I love checks. I hate tricks and you're a fake bitch. You're a fake bitch. I can spot you like you about to weight lift. Yeah. Bitch, I'm better than cake mix. But I can't be whipped with egg beaters. Nah. You cunts must be out of your labias and God's my alias. So if I don't have faith in me, then it basically makes me an atheist. Okay, here we go. I love checks and I hate tricks and you're a fake bitch, okay? So he's saying he loves checks, he's like he likes making money, he hates tricks as in, you know, hoes that are trifling, and you're a fake bitch. So trick as in fake bitch, all, you know, all in the same sort of ballpark there. Next line, I could spot you like you're about to weightlift. So you're spotting somebody during a weightlift. Now a lot of gym cells would understand this reference. I don't really weightlift because that is painful. I don't like doing it. Bitch, I'm badder than cake mix. That's a pretty shitty line. Like, I understand what you're getting at, bake batter, cake mix. I understand this. But again, very corny, unnecessary to put it in there unless you're trying to fill out filler into this verse. Because again, you're a 50-year-old guy who cannot fucking make a song that has substance in it anymore. Now, next line. You cunts must be out of your labias and God is my alias. So, you cunts as in like vaginas, you pussies, you bitches, must be out of your labias, which is, a body part over there, and God is my alias, as in he's so good, as a, you know, he's a rap god. So alias as in his nickname is rap god. Okay, so if I don't have faith in me, if I don't have faith in me, then it basically makes me an atheist. So he's God according to himself, metaphorically. So if he doesn't have faith in himself to be a good rapper, then it basically makes him an atheist, because relative to every other rapper, he's the best, he is the god. So if for him to not believe in him would be not believing in the God, which is very narcissistic for him to say it. But again, he's kind of over, he's a pretty average guy. So for him to say he's God is kind of just like him being tongue in cheek. Okay, so let's go ahead. Nate Diaz got the world by the tracheas and the chokehold and a sleeper. Yeah. Nate Diaz got the world by the trachea. It's like a chokehold and a sleeper. So, right here, so Nate Diaz, who's a UFC fighter, last time I checked, got the world by the trachea. So he's the Nate Diaz, the equivalent of, because he's got the world by the trachea with his rhymes. It's in a chokehold and a sleeper. So I don't understand the reference with the sleeper. I don't get it. Is that like a position in wrestling? I don't know. And me and Dre are like dog hair. We're both in our lab coats like retrievers, but like a... And me and Dre are in like dog hair. We're both in lab coats like retrievers. So again, golden retrievers have coats, as in the fur, the hair, and they're like dog hair because they're both in their respective metaphorical lab coats like a dog would, insofar as they are making music that we probably won't hear because they like to make us suffer. Doberman, I'm a whole different breed of animal mutt mixed with an overachiever. But like a Doberman, I'm a whole different breed of animal mutt mixed with an overachiever. So over here, he's saying he's like a Doberman, as in he's a mutt, or, you know, something completely different to a golden retriever. So animal mutt mixed with an overachiever. So it would be like animal mutt mixed with, like, you know, a Yorkie or like a pit bull, but he's saying with an overachiever, which rhymes with retriever, which is a sort of dog. And he's saying he's an overachiever because he does more than he has to, because he could have honestly retired 20 years ago and have a better legacy than he does now. But he's saying he's an overachiever. He'll keep going because, again, he has the delusion that he can still beat his 29-year-old self with his 50-year-old self. Same thing with Dr. Dre. That just simply has not happened yet. Oh, you're the king of rap. You're about to be overthrown like a pass over the head of an open receiver. Oh, you're the king of rap. You're about to be overthrown. So as in, you're the king of rap. And again, he's saying it as the rap god. So again, a king is nothing to a god. And you're about to be overthrown, as in like a coup de grace. A coup d'etat, right? You're about to overthrow the king. You're going to kill him and take his throne. And then like a pass over the head of an open receiver. Okay, so, oh, you're the king of rap. You're about to be overthrown like a pass over the head of an open receiver. So overthrown as in, you know, being taken over, having your throne be taken, and then overthrown as in like you threw it too high, and then like a pass over the head of an open receiver. Open receiver as in a wide receiver, not getting a catch because the quarterback throws it too high for him to catch. Again, an NFL reference, which is also ironic because this happens a lot. Goff, you know, not throwing it well enough for his receivers. And even if the receivers on the Detroit Lions got a ball in their hands, they cannot catch for shit because, again, the Lions suck ass, okay? Red Eagle on suicide watch. The Lions are awful. This shit could end up coming to blows like a wiener, but I ain't finished putting these holes through the ringer. And at least you can end up coming to blows like a wiener. Okay, so he's getting... Wait. At least you can end up coming to blows, so you can at least get... What? At least you can end up, like creaming to blows like a wiener. So coming to blows as in like fighting. So like he's saying you're a king and I'm a god and I'll at least be able to fight you. And you're going to get blows like as in like punches like a wiener as in like, you know, fellatio. And then, but I ain't finished putting these hoes through the ringer. The clothes in between the two rollers of weight. No, what I mean is flows in a woven. I treat them like thread. That's how I wind up sewing machine up. So. Okay, so he's putting the hose through the ringer as in like the washing, right? So you're washing clothes, like clothes, in between the two rolls is a weight. No, what I'm in this flow and are woven, I treat them like thread. That's how I wound up sewing machine up. I wound up sewing machine up. Now, that is extremely complicated and really good. So, again, he's saying, you know, I'm putting you through the ringer, reference to his 2018 song on the beginning track of the Kamikaze album, 2018. Eminem is saying, like clothes in between the two roll is a weight. I don't understand what that means. I don't wash clothes because I'm not a woman. I mean, he does know that reference. I don't know why. Anyways, what I'm in this flow interwoven. So again, he's interweaving everything, you know, the rhyme scheme about just general things as well as the double entendre he has with this like washing shit. And then he's saying, I treat it like thread. That's how I wound up sewing machine up. So he's treating this rap like thread, as in he's threading the needle. He is sewing stuff up, which is how he wound up sewing machine up. Machine as in Machine Gun Kelly. He ended up sewing him up, which is ironic because, again, yes, you did beat Machine Gun Kelly in the rap battle. But overall, you just gave him more clout than he did before. And also, on the other hand, you could have just not have dissed him at all. And then he would have just faded into obscurity as a rapper, you know, by like 2020. But instead, what you did was you pushed him into pop punk. So now he's the number one pop punk artist, okay? So now he's winning awards that you're not because you pushed him out of the league. So it's kind of analogous to saying, like, oh, Brady, he blew Kyler Murray into the MLB. Like, so that's kind of a win, because if you're playing at an elite level and you're winning the World Series as a Yankee, you know, on the MLB, who cares if you got blown the fuck out by Tom Brady, okay? Like, if Mahomes or Murray were still good in another sport, they're better off than flunking in the sport they're still in. Same thing with Machine Gun Kelly. Like, okay, yeah, sure, Eminem, you beat him at rap, but if he's going to be the number one pop punk artist, selling more copies than any Shady Records artist has in the last 5 years, then what does that say about you? Come on. So self-own, actually.
Don't fucks if you don't give them either time to ride or die, cause you're either boldly, you need to throw a middle finger up if you're rolling, but me, I'm gonna ride.
So fucks if you don't give me the time to ride or die, cause you are either both or you're neither. So you're either gonna ride with him or you're gonna die without him, I guess is what he's saying here. It's too complicated, I don't wanna think about it. Throw a middle finger up if you're rolling with me, but I'm gonna... So this is just a filler. The last three bars are pretty much filler as well. He just wanted to fill the beat out so that you can get to the chorus. That's a ton of bars, though. I'm not going to lie. And again, new flow as well. New bars. Yeah, and we can also review the actual intention of the lyrics as well. If you want to do that. I guess I can do it because I'm not good. So again, sewing machine up as a Machine Gun Kelly in a woven fabric. And again, I didn't read the genius for any of this beforehand, okay? So if you read lyrics, I explained them pretty well. I think I explained it pretty well. So yeah, this song was kind of complicated, especially the Eminem part. Is it kind of short? Yeah, I wish it were a little longer, but I don't really care. What would I rate it? Well, personally, I think the Dre verse was good. I think this first part is okay. I think the DOC hook is kind of shitty, I'm not going to lie. And then the Eminem verse was really great. And in fact, what I do appreciate about this is that he's rapping like he did, you know, on Music to Be Murdered By, the side B. But additionally, he's also not rapping as fast as he normally does, which sort of adds weight to what he's saying. And it also connotes a stronger voice inflection when he's speaking every syllable, because he doesn't have to force himself to go into a higher pitch to keep going faster at a constant rate without breathing heavier on the track. And therefore editing more, which cuts into the audio, and it's very complicated to explain. Point is that this flow is good, and it's a new sort of flow. I like it a lot. So I would rate Dr. Dre as a net positive for the song. The hook kind of sucks. The Eminem verse is great as well. So with that, I'm going to rate the song a 7 out of 10. It'd be a 9 if you improve the hook, but even without that, it's still a good song. Now, will it chart at all? Not really. But we don't really need it to. This is for the fans, I guess. And this is a good vibe, I guess, for the GTA soundtrack. But who gives a fuck about that game anyway? That has not been relevant for 5 years. I've not played it since, like, middle school, like, religiously anyway. So, yes, that is the game. Sorry, that is the song. I rate it a 7 out of 10. Comment down below if you like the breakdown, whether or not you think that I got a lyric wrong or anything you like in particular of the song. Comment down below anything you want to at all, as long as it isn't a porn bot, because I get those sometimes. You know, these third worlders will just come around and, you know, bot up your fucking comment section, something that very few will notice. Anyways, guys, thank you for watching the video. If you stuck around to the end, comment down below the number 47, because if you do, I'm going to do something special for you. I'm going to comment down something, blah, blah, blah. I'm going to comment something that is going to be a little factoid about Eminem. Anyways, I'm gone. Thank you. I'm out.